God wrote in the Ten Commandments that he created the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is in them in just 6 ordinary days. The genealogies in Genesis connect the lives of the early patriarchs straight back to Adam just thousands of years ago. So, how can we see the light from distant stars when it supposedly took billions of years for their light to travel to Earth? Does this disprove the clear timeline in the Bible and show the rest of it as just myth? Actually, it doesn't. Stay with us to find out why. You see, to measure the speed of light at any time in history, you need 6 things: light, space, distance, matter, time, and gravity. From a biblical perspective, God, who is outside of time and space, created all of these things during creation week. None of them even existed before that. Think about it. They all had to come into existence together at the same time. Without space, how can you have distance? Without distance, how can you measure speed or motion? What would matter be like without gravitational forces? And gravity even affects time. Light travels through this space-time fabric, and all of these things were spoken into existence by God during the first few days of creation. These are all pieces of a puzzle that came together at the beginning. Light is visible electromagnetic radiation that travels 186,000 miles per second when it's in a complete vacuum. The speed of light when traveling through space is impacted by gravity, and time and gravity are inseparably related. Gravity impacts the speed of light because it affects the energy of the fabric of space, which in turn affects the speed of light and time. Atomic clocks at different altitudes track time at different rates due to gravity. Even our GPS systems need to be calibrated for the effects that gravity has on time. Lastly, even motion itself affects time. When accelerating close to the speed of light, the weird distortions of Einstein's relativity kicks in. Time slows down, lengths go up, masses balloon, and everything we thought was fixed changes. So there we have it: light, space, distance, matter, time, gravity, and motion. Just put them all together at a given time in history, put them into a formula, and presto! We think we can measure just how and when it all got started. Apparently, looking back through millions of unseen years when the entire universe unfolded with this perfectly timed, perfectly bounded Earth spinning on its axis 1,000 miles per hour while orbiting the Sun at 67,000 miles per hour? Do any of us really know the complexities of light, space, distance, matter, time, gravity, and motion? Can we change the relationships between these on a grand scale in our universe today? Do we know for certain that their relationships today are the same as they were thousands of years ago? 5,000 years ago? What about when they were created? God is not bound by the laws of nature as we are. This is important to realize when it comes to the creation week, when God, who is outside of space and time, created the stars, light, space, distance, matter, time, and gravity. Even the evolutionary model, the Big Bang, has a light time travel challenge called the horizon problem, as explained by astrophysicist Dr. Jason Lyle.
The Big Bang, the alternative to biblical creation, also has a similar type of problem, a light travel time problem of its own. It's called the horizon problem. And basically, it has to do with the cosmic microwave background that we see streaming from the distant regions of the universe. We find that it's very uniform, and that shouldn't be, because in the Big Bang model, it should have different temperatures at different places. Why is it so uniform? Obviously, light energy had to travel from the hotter regions to the cooler regions to equilibrate those temperatures, but there hasn't been enough time. Even in 13.7 billion years, there's not enough time for light to travel from one side of the visible universe to the other. And so that's a light travel time problem for the Big Bang. It seems to me that if the alternative to biblical creation has the same type of problem as biblical creation, then you can't argue that distant starlight somehow disproves biblical creation in favor of the Big Bang. And after all, God is omniscient, and he could have used a mechanism that we do know about, or he could have used a mechanism that we don't know about. But it's not a problem for an infinite God to get light from distant galaxies to Earth in thousands of years.
It seems like God was anticipating the light time travel question when he asked Job to gird up his loins like a man and asked him, "Where is the way to the dwelling of light? And darkness, where is its place, that you may take it to its territory, that you may know the paths to its home? Do you know it because you were born then, or because the number of your days is great?" He even asked Job, "Do you know the ordinances of the heavens? Can you set their dominion over the earth?" I think this applies today. You see, we haven't always been here, and humans were certainly not here when these forces and laws had a beginning. We can measure how they interact in today's world, But don't you think they operated much, much differently when God put them here and shaped them during creation week? Can we really be certain that they operate the same way today as they did in the distant past? The first verse of the Bible reflects time in the beginning, energy God created, space, the heavens, and matter, the earth, all coming together for the very first time. We should be reminded by the psalmist, "By the word of the Lord the heavens were made, and all the host of them by the breath of his mouth. For he spoke, and it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast." How easily we forget that the natural laws at work today are not the same rules God used to create everything. The Bible is clear. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. So here we are, spinning 1,000 miles per hour on this globe, traveling around the sun at 67,000 miles per hour. And we think we can know with certainty the nature of light over millions of unseen years? God said something to the prophet Isaiah that sure seems to apply today. "For thus says the Lord, who created the heavens, who is God, who formed the earth and made it, who has established it, who did not create it in vain, who formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord, and there is no other." Physicist Dr. Russell Humphreys has developed a very practical and grounded theory that explains the light travel phenomena. First, a short background about Dr. Humphreys. In 1984, Dr. Humphreys developed a theory based on the biblical account, which says that God created the planets out of water just thousands, not millions of years ago. Dr. Humphreys' theory was able to make several testable predictions about the magnetic fields of Mercury, Mars, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. Then, years after Dr. Humphreys made his predictions, NASA space probes reached these planets and took measurements of their magnetic fields. The results? It turns out that Dr. Humphreys' predictions were right on, and the expectations of NASA, based on the evolutionary dynamo theory, were drastically off. Even with a magnetic field being 100,000 times smaller than expected, Dr. Russell Humphreys explains the light travel phenomena.
The fourth day, the Earth was just above a timeless level, and I'll explain what a timeless level is in a moment. But you see a cross-section of the trampoline here, and the vertical direction is gravitational energy, and the horizontal direction is distance away from the Earth. And you see a point at the distance away from Earth, which is billions of light years, drop down on the dotted line, and you see a little slice there that says that's a section of the waters above that are making the dent in the trampoline. So then you notice to the left of the waters above, it's mostly flat, except for a little tiny dent made by that green ball at the left, which is the Earth. That's right above a certain critical depth of gravitational energy where interesting things happen to time in Einstein's equations. So what happens to time is that below that critical level, there is no time. Time doesn't tick. You don't notice, you can't think, and there is no light, so it's dark. Here I'm going to begin to show you why this effect is so important in cosmology. Now, during the fourth day, God created the stars. Now, I'm going to suppose it's not necessary that God created the stars in a wave moving out from the Earth on the fourth day of creation. So now let's go back to a cross-section of our trampoline. Instead of looking down on it, let's look at the cross-section again. And the point of this is that new star masses, the stars that God made, the new ones he made, dented the trampoline yet further. So there's a wave of new stars, and you notice the dent has now tilted down, and it's really deep near the Earth, and it's shallow, a little shallower at the waters above. Okay, now we have a new scriptural effect to talk about, stretching out the heavens. God stretched the fabric of space. How do I know that? 17 verses that say things like this. God stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them out like a tent to dwell in. That's Isaiah 40:22. Imagine some big hands on our trampoline applying tension to the edges. So God stretched the fabric of space, and that would make the nearly flat region rise upward. So you can kind of imagine if you stretch the trampoline, you're going to apply more force to that ring that's sitting, making the dent, and it's going to pull it up. So here we are starting the action just after God has made the dent deeper with the stars, and now we're going to apply stretching and pull all of that up. So I want you to keep your eye on that vertical red arrow that's labeled event horizon. Things to the left of the event horizon are going to have no clocks ticking. They're going to be in the timeless zone. Things to the right of the event horizon have normal time. So you're going to watch as we stretch the fabric. We're going to raise the dent above that dotted line, and we're raising things above the timeless level. And you'll see the event horizon move to the left. And so as it moves to the left, more and more of the galaxies pop out of the timeless zone and start emitting light again. You notice it moved inward all the way to the center. And the last thing that the event horizon hits is at distance zero, which is at the Earth. So the Earth is the last thing to actually come above the event horizon. Remember, God made the new stars in a wave, and we're going to see that a timeless zone followed the new wave of stars. And then as stretching started pulling the dent out of the timeless zone, you're going to see the timeless zone here shrinking. So the Earth was the first into the timeless zone and the last out of the timeless zone. Earth time stopped during the fourth day, and the fourth day was only 24 hours of time here. If you had been there on the Earth at that point, you would have experienced no time during that timeless moment. It would not even be an eye blink. You would be able to suddenly see all the stars all at once. So the age of the universe, when Adam saw it, was just 6 days EST, Earth Standard Time. So when someone asks you how old the universe is, you should ask, whose clocks are you talking about? The ones that God gave are here on Earth. He wanted Adam and Eve to be able to see our own Milky Way. Some parts of it are 50,000 light years away from us. And Andromeda, which is 2 million light years away from us. You can see it as a patch in the northern sky. He wanted Adam and Eve to see the full glory of his universe. So I think you can see that there are answers to these questions from a biblical point of view. So I want you to be able to trust the Bible to be true.
For more details, see the video titled, Light Years? No Problem. Looking for answers about what the Bible teaches about creation, the fossil record, dinosaurs? Download the Genesis Apologetics app from the iTunes or Google Play stores for answers to these questions and more.